Well, I mean, look, you can say that Trump was untethered from the donors in a sense as well, because he didn't raise enough money from them. And so, hence, he was able to speak out more vociferously on social media, as Ocasio-Cortez does on the left. But I got to say one thing in her defense from what you just mentioned, Brian. Look, you say she doesn't do enough interviews on television now, but let's be fair. When she needed those interviews, you guys weren't there for her. So before the election, almost
all of the mainstream media covered. But our job isn't to be there.
No. But Brian, it isn't about being there or being or not. It's about you guys didn't think she had a chance, so you didn't give her any outlet at all, and so the people in her district didn't get a real sense of you know who had the better point of view. She overcame that anyway and went on to win. So if you think, hey, well, she's got to go on television to speak to the people, apparently she didn't. She had to go on the Young Turks and social media to speak to the people, and she did, and she won. So she doesn't owe television anything. She doesn't owe the corporate Democrats anything. She doesn't owe Republicans anything. So she can go on and make her case anywhere she likes, and it's incredibly effective.
She's an elected official.
I think
the
more interviews, the better.
She's an elected official. She certainly owes the media, the public, her voice in answering questions. I take your point about her not getting enough attention before she won, but I don't think that's particularly unusual for somebody running for Congress. She was not running for president. I think then it would be a different story.
Just real quick, look, I think that unfortunately the media covers people with more money, and a lot of that is corporate money. And so it's not just about Ocasio-Cortez, it's about the future. And in 2020, will you cover progressive candidates that run uncorrupted? And my guess is no, and then you'll turn around and sometimes blame them.
We should cover progressive candidates and conservative candidates. We should cover them and make sure people know about both of them. But
Absolutely, but unfortunately, you give an advantage to people with more money, and you do it all the time. And unfortunately, I think it aids and abets corruption.
I would love to discuss that more in the future. I'm not sure how we support candidates and have more donor money. That's your argument, that because they have more donor money, they get more news
coverage? Yeah. No, Brian, are you saying that not everybody in the media says, well, that person has a better chance of winning because they have more money, so there's this obsession with who's raised more money and hence is more legitimate? That's the view of the mainstream media, which is... and not held in the actual elections.
All right, interesting. Cenk, thanks so much for being here. Olivia, thanks to you as well.